Welcome back, and today we're going to be talking about signs of illness in a bird. So, signs of illness in your bird are typically going to be things that are kind of subtle and you can't really see them very well because of birds in the wild who normally hide their diseases or their sicknesses because of they'd be kicked out of their flock, and they don't want to be kicked out of their flock here at your home either. So they're going to hide their illnesses. So here's some ways to spot them. And you want to always look for them even if they are totally healthy birds, because they might just be sick the next day and it might be too late to get them taken care of. So the first sign of illness, you should take them to the vet. So the first sign of illness is less activity. So if your bird is being a little less active and they're just kind of just moping around and that's not normal for your bird, then you should definitely keep an eye on it. And if it gets worse, you should probably call a vet about it. Because if you don't call a vet soon enough, like I said, it can be too late and your bird can't be cured. If their eyes are not fully open, they're kind of just like this the whole time, and they're not like this, that can be a sign of illness as well, that they're not feeling good, because birds should normally have their eyes ready and alert. So, but if a bird's eyes are halfway closed and maybe some stuff coming out of it, then, or they're hazed over and they're kind of foggy and they're not as clear and bright as normal, you should take them to vet, because of that's not a good sign. That is a sign of illness, and you want to make sure you catch the illness before it gets too bad. Color changing feathers. So after a bird molts, their colors of their feathers will start to become a little bit brighter. Sometimes they'll be a little bit different. So you want to make sure that you pay attention if they're going through molts or if they're not, because some signs of a uncurable bird disease called PBFD, beacon feather disease, is uncurable, like I said, and their feathers' colors will change, and they only have about a few months to live once they have that. That's also a reason that it's kind of dangerous to take them to pet stores that have birds or bird stores, because dandruff of other birds, it's spread through the air of other parrots. So that is why I don't take my birds to pet stores, and that's why I always kind of quarantine my toys before I get them, give them to my birds, and that is why I like to order them online, because I know the other birds have not touched them. And I also shower or wash my hands really, really well after I've touched a bird, but a parrot, and after I shower after I've been around one for a while, because you don't know what that bird has and you can't see it until it gets too bad and noticeable for the vets to notice it. So that is why you want to be very careful. That's just one of the risks of having a bird.
Be very careful. That's just one of the risks of having a bird.
But you gotta deal with it. Feather plucking. So plucking can be a sign of boredom, sickness, or just sometimes it can be signs of molt because it hurts and they just want to get these feathers out so they can get their new ones, and sometimes they might pluck some pin feathers. So you want to make sure that you're paying attention, because that can be a sign of illness. And if they're plucking the feathers too much, that can sometimes be mites, bird mites, or bird lice and stuff. Really anything. So you don't really know. Lots of birds, when they have sicknesses, it can be in multiple things, because lots of the symptoms to this can be this, this, or this. So you really don't know. So you want to make sure that you take your bird to the vet immediately at the first sign of illness, because it could be a million different things, because a lot of these things have the same symptoms. So that's why it's good to get tests and stuff. Sitting in ill positions. So normally birds that are sick will sit with their head in their back. Now that can be sleeping sometimes, but normally it's a sign of illness and it's not good if your bird's doing that. So you want to make sure that you're paying attention and watching them while they are around you. Crested nose or eyes, which I said with the eyes, is it can be stuff coming out of them or it's cresting up. That's not good. You need to take them to the vet. And that can be multiple things as well. Getting extra weight and gaining it when they're not supposed to. So seeds are a big cause of birds becoming overweight and getting too fat. So you want to make sure you have them in the right diet and you're constantly paying attention to what they're eating, because birds can, like I said, get a lot of things where they are filled with air That can be some problems, lung issues, it can be diseases, mites, and stuff, because there are certain mites that will build up inside of your bird. They're not on the outside, they're inside, and it can kill them. So
that's disgusting. Don't like to think about that.
Trouble breathing. So if your bird's having trouble breathing, you want to pay attention. Is this just a certain thing? Or excess panting, which can also be because of wing clipping, because they're freaking out. So
make sure you're watching your bird at all times.
Falling off the perch. Falling off perches can be a sign of a really, really, really sick bird. And so you want to see if they're standing or gripping onto their perch, or they're just kind of not doing anything. And if they're falling, then they can have some really bad illnesses. And if they're sitting at the bottom of their cage, can be a sign of a dying bird or a just
very, 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 very sick bird.
He is looking at me like, I'm always watching. Clicking noises. So if you hear like these clicking noises where it sounds kind of like they're rubbing the top beak and their bottom beak together, that's what they're doing. But I'm about to see. I'm okay. It sounds like they're rubbing the bottom and their top beak together. That can be a sign of a comfortable, content budgie or bird. And I can breathe. If you hear your bird clicking or hear these rubbing together noises of their top and bottom beak, that can be a sign of a content bird, or it's happy. And it can also be a sign of a bird that's not feeling really well, that's feeling really bad. So you want to make sure you're paying attention. How many times did I say that? So you want to pay attention to your bird, because if they're like their foot's in their feathers and they're just standing, that's comfy. And if they're clicking while they do that, that can also mean that they're comfy and they're happy. And you want to make sure that you want to pay attention. Another sign is if your bird has slimy or wet droppings, because that's not normal. It should be solid. So if you see that, you should probably go check it out, look some things up, or take them to the vet, because that is not very good. One more thing is tail bobbing. So tail bobbing is basically when your bird is bobbing their tail, which they will be doing some of to keep their balance while they're staying on the perch. But if they just randomly tail bob, and it's very noticeable and you can see it very well, then you should call a vet, because it can sometimes be a lack of vitamin A and stuff, but you don't really know. So you wanna go check it out with your vet. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Go check out my websites. And obviously these are not the only signs of a sick bird, but you wanna make sure that you are paying attention, and anything that seems unnormal or it's just out of place and it doesn't make sense and your bird never acts like that, you should call a vet or get an appointment, because you don't want to wait too long before your bird. Also, sweet pea, one second. She has some pin feathers in her blue cheeks. Yeah. So, gotta keep an eye on those, right? Yeah. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. Bye.